A local jeepney manufacturer sees the PUV modernization program as a chance for the Philippines to industrialize. Francisco Motors says instead of importing modern jeepneys, the government should focus on local manufacturers, which it claims can build better vehicles. The local firm also reveals it will be building a 200-hectare special eco-zone in Camarines Norte, where other local manufacturers can produce affordable e-jeepneys.
The jeepney manufacturing of Francisco Motors is just a tiny part of the bigger project that we are doing, because we are developing a special economic zone, a 200-hectare special economic zone in Camarines Norte, of which the jeepney manufacturer is just one of those locators in that economic zone, wherein we are inviting all of the suppliers in the supply chain of the manufacturing of electric jeepneys to locate in that special economic zone. So this endeavor will generate a lot of jobs for Filipinos here at home, of which if we continue to import minibuses from other countries like China, India, or wherever, we are taking away jobs that are supposed to be for the Filipino workforce.
Francisco Motors also explains its ambitious plan to provide operators with free modern jeepneys.
Pwedeng sumali dito ay yung mga jeepney operators with valid franchises. So it could be ano, yung mga transport cooperatives, transport corporations. Lahat ng sasali, meron sila mga lumang jeep. Diba? So yung mga lumang jeep nila, we can still use them to operate them and help them na lumaki yung kita nila, because we will have the unlimited rides na ano, na tickets. Kapag sumakay ka ng train, you can buy a ticket, you can hop on, hop off unlimited times in a day or in a week or in a month. So depende sa ticket na bibiliin mo. So kung kayang gawin yun ng developed countries, why can't we do it here? Ang problema kasi ng ano, ng mga operators natin is the cost ng mga sasakyan. So kung ang problema nila ay cost, bakit ang solusyon is hindi pa utangin? Di ba? We create a business model na hindi yung lulubog sila sa utang. We create a business model that is sustainable enough that we can actually give the jeepneys for free. So dito sa unlimited rides tickets na to, dyan kukunin yung sweldo ng mga drivers, dyan kukunin yung kita ng mga transport cooperatives.
Philippine transport regulators vow their readiness for the looming transport strike to be launched by groups opposing the government's PUV modernization program. Jeepney groups Manibela and Piston will be holding a series of protest actions against the controversial modernization scheme beginning Monday, that's April 15. The protests will conclude on April 30, the deadline for jeepney operators to join a cooperative which will replace their fleet with safer and less polluting vehicles to improve the transport system as a whole. The LTFRB now reminding protesters to conduct an orderly strike.
Pinaghanda na po namin yung paglalagay ng mga rescue vehicles po sa mga possible areas na magkakaroon po ng problema. There are about 4 areas po na natukoy po namin na pwedeng magkaroon po ng shortage sa public transport. Magpapakalat po kami ng mga MMDA po at saka police to maintain peace and order. Kasi po ang palagi naming napapansin, hinaharang po yung mga pampublikong sasakyan na wala naman pong balak sumama sa kanila. Kuminsan ho nagtatapon ng spike sa daan para po yung mga goma ng mga ayaw sumama sa kanila ay mabutas.
The Philippine National Police says it will launch mobility assets to aid affected passengers.
Bibigay po natin sa kanila yung araw na yan, of course, but we will exercise as usual yung maximum tolerance para naman po hindi po magkakaon ng anumang gulo kung darating po yung araw na talagang magrarally po sila sa mga kalsada po natin.
President Marcos earlier this week asserted the finality of the April 30 deadline, echoing remarks from transport officials who say nearly 80% of jeepney operators have already consolidated. The Metropolitan Manila Development Authority clarifies the modified working hours for government offices in the metro is not rigid. LGUs in Metro Manila were mandated to adjust working hours in government offices to 7 a.m. to 4 p.m. from the current 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. window starting Monday, that's April 15th. This is part of government's efforts to ease traffic congestion in the region during rush hours. But MMDA says government agencies can still implement other schedules best suited for them.
Yung 7 to 4 naman po, general rule po yun. Pero pwede naman po mag-adjust ang MGU, ang mga government agencies. Kung ano yung suited sa kanila, meron pong nagsasabi na mas preferred nila yung 4-day work week. Pero ang nakasentro po ito na 7 o'clock, magsisimula na po yung servisyo publiko. At natatapos po ng 4. Yung iba naman po, ang gagawing 4-day work week, tapos alternate po. Para lang po maikalat yung ating mga empleyado sa mas maraming oras o araw para po hindi po magkasabay-sabay sa pag-commute.
Meanwhile, the Metro Manila Council says some government workers will still stay in their offices until 5 in the afternoon to cater to the public as they adjust to the new schedule.
Hindi naman po makakadisrupt sa serbisyo ng lungsod ang isang oras. At mag-iiwan naman po tayo ng skeletal force from 4 p.m. to 5 p.m. for frontline services dahil baka meron pa rin mga darating po between 4 p.m. to 5 p.m. Asahan po nila na meron pa rin skeletal workforce na may iwan po sa City Hall.
Some bad news for motorists. Oil prices seen rising for a fourth straight time this week or next week. The Philippine Energy Department expects gasoline to increase by up to 20 centavos, while diesel and kerosene may climb by as much as 1 peso next Tuesday. The DOE still attributes the higher pump prices to the ongoing conflict in the Middle East, particularly in Gaza. Now, 6 Philippine municipalities are expected to endure dangerously high temperatures today. That's Friday. State Weather Bureau Pagasa says the areas, including Puerto Princesa City in Palawan and Cotabato City in Maguindanao, will experience a heat index of between 42 to 51 degrees Celsius. Under these circumstances, Pagasa warns heat exhaustion and heat cramps are likely, while heat stroke is possible for those exposed for extended periods. The months of March, April, and May are usually the hottest for the Philippines, but temperatures have been worse due to the prevailing El Nino phenomenon. This has prompted labor groups to call for so-called heat breaks and schools to suspend in-person classes. The National Food Authority Council has approved a higher buying price for unhusked rice, locally known as palay, to stay competitive. Under the new guidelines, dry palay can be bought from 23 to 30 pesos per kilo, while fresh palay will have a buying price of 17 to 23 pesos. This is higher than the previous 19 to 23 pesos buying kilo or per kilo buying price for both fresh and dried unhusked rice. The move comes after NFA reported it has been struggling to procure palay this harvest season due to lower prices compared to private counterparts. Aside from the approval of higher buying prices, the NFA Council also approved a program that will modernize their operations.